A very good evening to you, my brothers and sisters and children who are gathered here. We are very happy to have our main celebrant this evening, the Nuncio Archbishop Marek Zalewski. Let us welcome him warmly and thank him. He has made a special effort to be here as if he's going to be flying off to Vietnam for official duties today. So we are very grateful that he has made this sacrifice to be here. So let us invite him and we proceed with the opening prayer.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these holy mysteries. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Oh,
Let us pray. O God, who raised up St. Ignatius of Loyola in your church to further the greater glory of your name, grant that by his help we may imitate him in fighting the good fight on earth and merit to receive with him a crown in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. O Lord, you have enticed me, and I was enticed. You have overpowered me, and you have prevailed. I have become a laughingstock all day long. Everyone mocks me. For whenever I speak, I must cry out. I must shout. Violence and destruction. For the word of the Lord has become for me a reproach and derision all day long. If I say, I will not mention him or speak any more in his name, then within me there is something like a burning fire shut up in my bones. I am weary with holding it in, and I cannot. The word of the Lord.
Taste and see, taste. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do everything for the glory of God. Give no offense to Jews or to Greeks or to the Church of God, just as I try to please everyone in everything I do, not seeking my own advantage, but that of many, so that they may be saved. Be imitators of me, as I am of Christ. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Large crowds were traveling with Jesus. And he turned and said to them, "Whoever comes to me and does not hate father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, yes, even life itself, cannot be my disciple. Whoever does not carry the cross and follow me cannot be my disciple. For which of you, intending to build a tower, does not first sit down and estimate the cost, to see whether he has enough to complete it? Otherwise, when he has laid a foundation and is not able to finish, all who see it will begin to ridicule him, saying, 'This fellow began to build and was not able to finish.' Or what king, going out to wage war against another king, will not sit down first and consider whether he is able with 10,000 to oppose the one who comes against him with 20,000? If he cannot, then, while the other is still far away, he sends a delegation and asks for the terms of peace. So therefore, none of you can be my disciple if you do not give up all your possessions." And this, my dear friends, is the good news of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, I am pleased to be with you this year again to celebrate the liturgical memorial of one of the greatest saints in the history of the Church, Saint Ignatius of Loyola. This is also a very significant event as we celebrate
the closing of the Ignatian year from May 2021 until tomorrow, 31st July 2022. May 20th, 2021 marked 500th anniversary of St. Ignatius' conversion. That fateful day when Ignatius, the soldier, struck by a cannonball, began his transformation into Ignatius the Pilgrim. The theme for the Ignatius year is to see all things new in Christ. Saint Ignatius Loyola worked to strengthen the kingdom of God on earth by trying to be like Christ in everything he did. The words of today's gospel, "Who is unable to take the cross and follow me cannot be my disciple." And I think that these words struck St. Ignatius at a certain moment, and he decided really to take his cross and follow Jesus very closely. You know, Ignatius was born probably in 1491 at the castle of Loyolas in Spain, and he was baptized Eneco, a Spanish name, in honor of the 11th century abbot of the Benedictine monastery of Ona. He had five sisters and seven brothers, and grew up in a noble Catholic family that prided itself on its military past and its fidelity to the king. Very colorful life of St. Ignatius, before conversion and after conversion. He was also arrested once with his brother Lopez for the things that are not morally and socially accepted. But after this, God has chosen him, showed him the way, talked to him, and he understood and accepted the message of the Lord. Then he was also injured during the battle in Pamplona. Both legs were damaged by a cannon shot. And he attributed his recovery to Saint Peter, to whom he had a special devotion. During his long and boring convalescence at Loyola, he spent many long hours daydreaming of courtly love. Finally, because there were no other books, it's providential also this, not other books available, he read a very famous book, The Life of Christ, and the golden legend that despite the saints as knights of God, dedicated to their eternal Lord Jesus Christ. After this, important changes took place in his soul. Periods of great depression, doubts, temptations, disgust, and scruples alternated with periods of great spiritual joys. He discovered the root of the scruples and decided never again to confess past sins, and from that day forward, he was free of scruples and held it as certain that Jesus desired his to be free. Then, later on, another interesting fact, St. Ignatius, as a young man, decided or intended going to the Holy Land, but due to war between Venice and the Turks, he went to Rome instead. And in the chapel of La Storta, north of Rome, he felt a great change in his soul. And he so clearly saw God the Father placed him with Christ that he had no doubts that God the Father did place him with his Son. In the Basilica of Santa Maria Maggiore in Rome, that many of us visited, St. Ignatius, during Christmas 1538, celebrated his First Holy Mass. In Rome, he taught the spiritual exercises, and during his time in Rome, his mystical life reached its maturity. Then, by the end of 1539, he had written the part of the future constitution of the Company of Jesus, the Society of Jesus, or Jesuits' Father, that our fathers here present, they still learn and observe what Saint Ignatius has written. And another important day, July 21st, 1550, Pope Julius III solemnly established the order, the Company of Jesus, established the order of Jesuits. And Ignatius opened a college in Rome for young men entering the order and set up college also in Jerusalem, Cyprus, and Constantinople at that time. Yeah? Then he died in July 1556. And his death, interesting also this fact, the Society of Jesus had about 1,000 members and, imagine, 100 houses throughout the world. He was canonized by Pope Gregory XV in 1622. This is short curriculum vitae of Ignatius, but very significant also for us. And my proposal, my invitation is, if you have chance, or you don't have other books, close the internet, close the mobile phone, iPad, and read something about Saint Ignatius' life. Imitate him, since you live in the parish dedicated to him. He is our heavenly patron. And I am sure you will discover many nuances, many aspects of life unknown to you till now. Dear brothers and sisters, in the vision Ignatius encountered at La Storta, close to Rome, he saw Jesus carrying the cross, and Ignatius prayed to the Father to place in these words, "Father, place me with your Son." Later, he advised someone complaining of her suffering. He said, "If God causes you to suffer much, it is a sign that he has great designs for you and that he certainly intends to make you a saint. And if you wish to become a great saint, enter him yourself and treat him yourself to give you much opportunity for suffering. For there is no wood better to kindle the fire of holy love than the wood of the cross, which Christ used for his own great sacrifice of boundless charity." End of the quote. Although the cross is central to Ignatian spirituality, it is not a sad or gloomy kind of spirituality. Because Saint Ignatius, at one point, he commented, "Few souls understand that God would accomplish in them if they were to abandon themselves to him, and if they were to allow his grace to mold them accordingly." Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, while wishing all the best for Father Colin, your parish priest, the community of Jesuit fathers, and all the parishioners, let us conclude this reflection by joining Saint Ignatius in his prayer for generosity. "Lord, teach me to be generous. Teach me to serve you as you deserve, to give and not to count the cost, to find and not to heed the wounds, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labor and not to ask for reward, save that of knowing I do your will. Amen." profess now our faith. Please stand up. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. Again on the third day, in a corner, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. Of sins. Dear brothers and sisters, today we are reminded to focus on serving God and not accumulating earthly treasures. Let us bring our prayers and petitions to God with full faith that He will provide for our every need.
Let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church, as we conclude the celebrations of the Ignatian year, that we may continue to be inspired by Saint Ignatius to walk on our pilgrim journey on earth, serving others with peace, justice, and compassion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders dealing with the global energy and food crisis, that they will promote the common good and the well-being of the earth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are in pain and enduring challenging life circumstances, that the Holy Spirit will bring healing to those struggling with illness, protection to refugees, and comfort and strength to the isolated and the grieving. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish community as we celebrate our feast day, that we will open ourselves to grow in faith and in our willingness to work for the greater glory of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
In the silence of our hearts, let us pray for the intentions offered at this Mass, for each other, and for our personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Loving God, you never cease to forgive and heal us. Give us hearts of mercy to tend your children on earth. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
As you know, we are not making an in-person collection, so we invite you to help us in your generous donation by using the PayNow. The UN number is there, and those of you who want to scan the code is also in front of the pew. So we invite you to make your generous donation for this Mass collection. Thank you.
Thank you.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May these offerings we make to you as we celebrate Saint Ignatius be pleasing, Lord God, and grant that the sacred mysteries which you have made the fount of all holiness may sanctify us too in the truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you summon us to imitate the disciple of Saint Ignatius, that we may hear the voice of the Spirit with docile and trusting hearts, and you move us to conform our life to Christ, that we might imitate him, the model of every virtue. Through him, O Father of mercy, we are preordained by you that by responding to your gifts, we may complete the journey of faith, be sustained by the support of hope, be refreshed by the strength of love. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the host of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously made holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with Saint Ignatius of Loyola, and all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm with faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of God, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. My soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. May the sacrifice of praise that we have offered with thanksgiving in honor of Saint Ignatius, O Lord, bring us to exalt your majesty without end. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for just some very short announcements. Kindly be reminded that the Kingsmead Hall compound car park at 8 Victoria Park will be closed from 4 p.m. onwards on Sunday tomorrow in view of our feast day celebrations, and especially for those participating in the pilgrim walk and the fellowship, you are encouraged to take public transport to get to your starting points and to also go back home after the event from where you are. Because there will be two walking points, as you know. One is from Botanic Gardens and the other one is from the Ghim Moh area. So those who are taking part, we ask you to take public transport to get to your destination. And there will be a bit of celebration and fellowship at the end of the walk. Huh? There's quite a big program planned for you also. And then on behalf of the PPC Exco and the parish staff and the Jesuit community at Kingsmead Hall, we'd like to wish all parishioners a very joyous and spirit-filled feast day. Happy feast day. And truly, we are very grateful to Archbishop Marek for the time that he has taken to prepare the homily and to make a special effort to celebrate this feast day with us. When he was first appointed as Apostolic Nuncio, that was the first year that he came in 2018, really about 4 years ago, that we invited him here. And this is the second time he's back here. So we are very grateful to you, Archbishop Marek. All right, thank you. God bless you. Just as a quick one before we pass it back up. Following this, there will be a short break, you know, meaning those of you who are attending the concert at 8 p.m. If you have booked, you'll be welcome to come. If you're not booked, it depends on whether we have enough space to take you in, so you could be on the wait list, okay? Yeah. So, thank you. Yeah.
Please stand up for the final apostolic blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Truth to death.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, we would like you to actually vacate the church, this hall, because we are going to be resetting the hall for the concert. Even if you do have tickets, you have to get out so that we can check you in again. Please do not leave your valuables or anything behind that you're going to chop seats or anything like that. I'm sorry, but do help us in trying to reset the space for the concert. Thank you very much. Yeah, because there will be a sound check that will be going on. So if you could kindly leave after you said your personal prayers, that would be much appreciated. Thank you so much.